another day. Thank you very much for tuning in Harvey's Earth and Beyond. And we are going to have another super show, as we usually do every Friday night. So what are we going to talk about? There was an article in the Telegraph, which I had buried in my files. And it's a very good article. Okay, and it deals with alien life and UFOs. Top 10 believers. Now, NASA research has found that half of all the stars in the universe have Earth-like planets orbiting around them, raising fresh hopes of finding alien life. Now, numerous public figures, from eminent scientists to politicians, have stated their belief in the existence of alien life forms and UFOs. And here we take a look at some of the most notable claims. One, Professor Stephen Hawking. Last year, the revered physicist and cosmologist suggested that extraterrestrials almost certainly exist, but that humans should be taking steps to avoid them rather than seek them out. Now, number two is Lord Rees. The Astronomer Royal last year said he believed aliens could well exist and warned that they might prove to be beyond human understanding. I suspect there could be life and intelligence out there in forms we can't conceive, he said. And just as a chimpanzee can't understand quantum theory, it could be there are aspects of reality that are beyond the capacity of our brains, he said. The third person was Lazar Filipov, a Bulgarian government scientist from the country's Space Research Institute, claimed 2 years ago that they were already in contact with extraterrestrial life. They claimed that experts were trying to decipher a complex set of symbols sent to them after posing aliens a list of 30 questions. It was revealed that the center's researchers were analyzing 150 crop circles from around the world, which they believe answer the questions. Aliens are currently all around us and are watching us at the time, Mr. Filipov said. And they are not hostile towards us, rather they want to help us, but we have not grown enough in order to establish a direct contact with them. Then there's Edgar Mitchell, the former NASA astronaut, claimed in 2009 that alien life exists, but that the U.S. government was covering up the evidence. And Mr. Mitchell, who was part of the 1971 Apollo 14 moon mission, made the claims in a talk to the 5th annual X Conference, a meeting of those who believe in UFOs and other life forms. Then there's Jimmy Carter, the U.S. president from 1976 to 1980, promised while on the campaign trail that he would make public all documents on UFOs if elected. He said, I don't laugh at people anymore when they say they seen UFOs. I seen one myself. And then number six is General Douglas MacArthur. The Korean and Second World War soldiers said in 1955 that the next war will be an interplanetary war. The nations of the Earth must someday make a common front against attack by people from other planets. The politics of the future will be cosmic or interplanetary. Then there is number seven, is Monsignor Corradil Balducci. The Vatican theologian said extraterrestrial contact is a real phenomenon. The Vatican is receiving much information about extraterrestrials and their contacts with humans from its embassies in various countries such as Mexico, Chile, and Venezuela. Number eight is Air Chief Marshal Lord Dowding, the Second World War RAF fighter commander during the Battle of Britain, once said of UFOs, I am convinced that these objects do exist and that they are not manufactured by any nations on Earth. Nine, Ronald Reagan. The U.S. president from 1980 to 1988 claimed he had seen a UFO himself. He said, I looked out the window and saw this white light. It was zigzagging around. I went up to the pilot and said, have you ever seen anything like that? And he was shocked, and he said, nope. And I said to him, let's follow it. And we followed it for several minutes. It was a bright white light, and we followed it to Bakersfield. And all of a sudden, to our utter amazement, it went straight up into the heavens. And when I got off the plane, I told Nancy all about it. Then there's Mikhail Gorbachev, the USSR's last head of state. The phenomenon of UFOs does exist and must be treated seriously. So this is from a very interesting newspaper, The Telegraph. I just thought I would mention that. All right.